are given, usually it's in terms of t, right? We have x equals f of t, y equals g of t, and yeah, you assume that the derivatives exist up to the second derivative, so you know there will be the dominant ones, okay? So again, we need to find our curvature. What should we do? So curvature is the absolute value of the rate of change of theta with respect to x, right?
Okay, so we're still in x, y.
No, there's still x, y, but now there's a parameter t.
No. I'm saying that we're still in the x, y plane.
Yes. These are all for plane curves. We're not yet in space. Remember, for space, we cannot do theta. Remember that story? We don't have a theta in space. We don't know what we're talking about. What theta, right? Only in the plane because it's flat. We have theta. All right? Okay. Again, how can we do this? We don't have an s, but we have a t. So what can we do with d theta ds? We can write it as what? D theta dt times dt ds. Whoa, would that work? Okay. D theta dt times dt over ds. Which we can actually write as a division problem. We can write it as what? The numerator is d theta dt. And what's the denominator?
Ds
dt. Is that okay? Is that better? D theta dt over ds dt. Now again, remember, what is d theta dt? You did it when you were doing your parametric equation.
Wait, no, it's not k.
Oh, sorry. Do I need a picture? Isn't the rate of change of theta again has something to do with the slope, right? Correct? Rate of change of theta with respect to time is the slope of the curve at that point. Which, how did you calculate when you were doing parametric equations back in Calc 2? It's what? Rise over run. What? G prime of t, right? Correct? G prime of t over f prime of t. Or maybe that's not d theta. Is that d theta? No, that's not d theta dt. It's similar to... I'm tired already. It's because I have to get the d theta dt. This is your tangent. Oh, you hate me. It's similar. It's late. It's almost 9. It's similar to the discussion we were doing over there, which is tangent theta is the slope of the curve, right? At the point, isn't it rise over run? Correct? All right? So it has to be g prime of t over f prime of t. You still okay? Just like what we did earlier, because I don't like tangent theta, but I want theta, how can I write theta?
Tangent
inverse. It's tan inverse of this, right? G prime of t over f prime of t. And now that I have that, am I ready to get d theta dt?
Yes.
Yes, right? So let me write it here. So what is d theta dt? I have tan inverse of this thing. Just like what we did over there, or whenever, if you have tan inverse of something, the derivative is what?
1 plus
the square of that, right? G prime of t over f prime of t squared, right? Times what? The derivative of this thing, right? But this thing looks like a quotient. So now it's time. I don't know if you've heard this. I'm from the Philippines, and in the Philippines, we yodel. We yodel. We say, well, if it's a quotient, we say low D high minus high D low all over low. Have you heard of that?
Yeah.
All right. So it's a quotient. therefore we say, low D high. So what's the D high?
G double prime.
G double prime of D minus high D low is what? F double prime of D all over low square. No, 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 F prime, right?
Yeah.
You yield it. Okay?
F single prime of D.
Single, right? F single prime of T square. And then of course all you have to do is simplify this. Daniel is like it's just a lot of tedious work. Okay, question?
So where did you get 1 plus and then that squared? Because what I did, I just plugged in theta for that. For 10.
No, 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 remember theta is, isn't it when you have derivative of 10 inverse of u?
Oh, that's what it means.
Is what? 1 over 1 plus u squared, derivative of u with respect to whatever letter you're doing.
Oh, so I didn't.
Right? So this is t, so then you have. Okay. That's what we're doing, okay? So derivative of 10 inverse is 1 over 1 plus that u squared. Exactly like what we did over here, right? For Cartesian. Are you still with me?
Yes.
Did you not like my yodeling? Okay. And we can simplify this, and maybe we can now talk of the curvature. Come on, guys, we can do this.
Yes.
Curvature is given by what? Absolute, let's just put absolute value for everything, is what?
Yeah.
F prime
of
T, G double prime of T, minus G prime of T, F double prime of T. Wait, wait, wait. Okay, let's look at what happens to the denominator. Here, so these guys will get multiplied together, right? When you multiply these two together, what will you get? F prime of T squared, right? Plus G prime of T squared. Did I do it right?
Yes,
I believe so.
Is that it? No, to the 3/2, right? Yeah, that's it. Oh, no, no, we're not done. I know, I jumped. I said, no, no, that's not the correct formula. That's not K. Ramka said, no, you're not off the hook yet. No, this is not yet K. Because this guy is just for whom? This is just for D theta dt. We're in calculus day, guys. What do you expect?
Okay. Sunshine and rainbows.
So we just got the top. Now how do we get the ds dt? We still need the ds dt, but we know how to do that, right? For parametric equations, for parametrically defined, for parametrized curves, what's ds dt? Isn't it just the square root of F prime of T squared, right? Plus G prime of T squared, correct? So, okay, let's see. So anyway, I wanted to go home already. Okay. It's not yet the curvature, but I got it because I said, no, I need something to the 3/2. Now, do you see where my 3/2 is coming from? So therefore now I can write the formula for the curvature. Curvature is what? Is F prime of T, G double prime of T minus G prime of T, F double prime of T, all over, do you see the 3/2, guys? F prime of T squared plus G prime of T squared, this quantity raised to the 3/2. Did I do it right?
Yeah.
I think so, okay.